From Far Above Rubies, and today I'm going to be doing a Polaroid Instax Mini 8 101 tutorial. So it is going to be the way that I take my pictures, how to use, where to buy, and all of those kind of details. So make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Also, comment down below any video requests you have for our upcoming series and this series. Make sure to follow us on our social media, which will be linked somewhere around the screen, and hit the subscribe button. Let's get into it. So the way I got inspired to buy a Polaroid was actually from Instagram. So I was just on Alicia Marie's Instagram and I saw this really cute little camera and I really wanted one. And so the first thing I decided to do was research, because if I went on Michael's website, it was actually $120. But when I went on Amazon, it was actually only $67. So I'm glad I did the research first, because the film is cheaper and the camera is actually cheaper on Amazon. And then I just shipped it right to my house, and I actually have Prime, so it was shipped there pretty quickly. So I was super excited when my Polaroid and my film came in the mail, which it would never actually come like this, but it came in the mail, and right away I opened it, and I was super excited to see what was inside. And I actually got my film pack off Amazon and my camera off Amazon. The film pack was $16 for 20 film. So right as I opened it, I thought it was super cute, and I was very excited. The first thing you should do, even though it is a little bit more time consuming, is read the instructions thoroughly, because there was a lot of things I didn't know before about the instructions. And of course it seems like, oh my goodness, this is a whole bunch of instructions, this is gonna take me hours. But realistically, it was only because it was in multiple languages, so you only had to read one, and it didn't take me that long just to read through it, and that was a really important part because it helped me know everything what to do. And finally, once I was done reading the instructions, make sure to keep them somewhere that you will remember where it is. So I just folded it back up and put it inside the box because I will need it one day. And here is just the film pack that I got. I have already used it, but what you will do is you will turn it around and there will be a little spot. It will be a black box, and there in the corner, in the right corner, you can see how many film you have, and you will pull open and you will match up the little yellow dot with the yellow on the film. Here is where the film will come out of once it is done, and you also need to make sure that you see how much film you have left, and now you're ready to take your pictures. You just click the little button in the bottom and that will open up the camera. And you need to make sure that it's on the right setting that it wants it to be on. It will make a little red dot, and that's the setting you know that it should be on. There's a house, there's clouds, extra cloudy. High key mode is to make it extra bright if you're at night. Now, how I take my photos is I just take them. I have never actually taken a photo. I've always had other people take them of me. So all of my pictures are other people taking them. And when you're taking your photos, make sure you have the right lighting. And something not to do is take them at night. I have done this a couple times. Sometimes your face will come washed out. So I decided to use the high key mode, but the high key mode made it more washed out. So I really recommend always taking them in the day, because you don't want to risk losing a piece of film because it is expensive. Another thing I have seen people do is take selfies. So I don't know if I would always recommend this. I have never done it, just because you can't see yourself, and if you were cut off, that would be wasting an entire piece of film. So maybe if you want to take a selfie, have someone look through the hole to make sure that you are seen. Another super important part is cleaning your Polaroid. I just use baby wipes because mine gets very dirty because of its light pink color. And here's my little DIY Polaroid string I made. I just took some string and little clips and I made this bow out of fabric and lace. So I put them all together and I rolled it up and put the little piece around it. And I got these little clips from Michaels that I just clipped it onto a string and tacked it to my wall. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure to give us a big thumbs up. Also, if you haven't already, make sure to comment down below any video requests you have and hit the subscribe button and follow us on our social medias. Bye, guys!